Hi, this is Russ Andersson with perhaps the silliest tutorial ever. We're going to be talking about the coordinate system today, and I know a lot of people have trouble reading about that and visualizing what's going on. So what I've done here is set up a completely real-world example of what's going on. So you have to bear with me a little. It is silly, but hey, hopefully you learn a lot from it. So here we go. Our task for today is to take our animated Pokey here, and he's going to walk into the house. Okay? Now here, this is our 3D coordinate system inside of SynthEyes and inside of Maximi or whatever. And it's a completely different thing. It can be anywhere here. There's nothing to say where this goes in the scene. So, you know, maybe in this 3D environment, we built Pokey, so he's sitting right here at the origin in the coordinate system, and we want to get him into the scene. So what do we need to do? First off, let's take a look at what we've got. We've got some trackers out in the scene. Now these are just 2D things that SynthEyes has been able to track. Now inside the software, also after it's solved, you wind up with a matching bunch of 3D coordinates. So for every individual tracker out in the scene here, this is the 2D one that's in the image, but somewhere out here in the 3D environment, there's a matching 3D coordinate for that particular tracker. Now the deal is, there's nothing that says where these guys go in here at all either. So no matter where I put the coordinate system here, if I just take some default setting, SynthEyes is always going to go and figure out where to put the trackers relative to this coordinate system and its origin here so that everything matches up and my trackers all wind up where they were, where they need to go. And so when you do that, SynthEyes is calculating those positions with respect to this origin and the coordinate axes of your 3D environment. So, you know, I can put down the coordinate system there and compute one set of values for each of these guys, put the coordinate system over here, get another set of coordinates. Wherever I put it, SynthEyes is always able to compute where things go in order to line up properly with the features in 2D. Now that doesn't work out too well for Pokey here. If we throw down Pokey here, you know, he's sitting in the coordinate system here. So if he's sitting over here and we want him really over in front of the door, he's going to be in the wrong spot. So the name of the game is to put him someplace in the scene that's convenient, maybe that corresponds to where you want to have him go, maybe that this is actually a building and we want to put a building into this scene in exactly the right surveyed location. So what to do? Here's our matching coordinate in SynthEyes. So let's think about what the star 3 button does. That's really what we're going to be following. The star 3 button lets you click on 3 successive trackers. And the first tracker you click on is going to be the origin tracker. So you click on this tracker, and you can click it in the 2D or in the 3D workspace. It doesn't matter. But what it tells SynthEyes to do is to take the 3D position of this guy and move it to the origin. Now since, and it locks it at that position. Now since it still has to match up with what's in the scene, SynthEyes then has to go and pull the whole coordinate system down so that your tracker still is sitting at the origin, and oh, it's also still sitting at that location in the scene. So I'm just going to move this guy out of the way a little. So now I've set up one initial constraint on what's going on. But look, I can go and move this coordinate system around all kinds of different ways, right? And it still has the origin at that location that I've set. And SynthEyes can still take each one of these guys and figure out, oh, you know, it has to be over here in order to accommodate this particular coordinate system. But this isn't going to be a too useful one. So what we might want to say is, oh, you know, hey, here's my matching one over here for this. You know, I want this one to match up along this x-axis. So that's the second one that I've clicked on. And that pulls the coordinate system down so that this x-axis tracker lines up there, and it has to be there. Now, my coordinate system can still move around like this, but it can't move at all like this or like this anymore. It's locked at those two particular positions, so there's only kind of this one rotation axis that's still remaining. So now, perhaps what I see is that, oh, here's another tracker back there, and really it should be on this same plane. This is our ground plane. So I want that one to also match up so that it falls onto there. So the only way for that to happen is for this to lie flat so that the situation looks like that. So I've told SynthEyes what it is that I want to have happen. I want you to move the coordinate system around so that the one tracker has to match up at this spot, has to match up here along the x-axis, and this other guy over here has to fall onto this ground plane. And really, it doesn't matter where this guy is over here at all, see? It's just the fact that it has to be on that, and it prevents the whole coordinate axis from lifting up into the air. Now, there's one other detail I don't show, and I can't really show here, which is the second point has the size of the scene also. Because when you click on that second one, it puts it not only along the x-axis, but at a particular distance. It defaults to 20 units along the x-axis. So to make that happen, it actually goes, and so suppose 20 units is out here, but the coordinate's here, it would actually go and shrink the entire scene down so that that 20 units shows up at the right spot. You want to look at it the other way around, it expands the real world. But one way or another, if our real world, you know, it would kind of be shrinking Pokey. Pokey's here in the whole real world. The whole Pokey would shrink down to fit exactly into that space that we've asked for. So that second point sets up the scaling. You can also just go back after you've set up the coordinate system and tell it just to be on the x-axis that it's not a lock point. The lock point that says, oh, it should be at exactly 20:00, and say just have it on the x-axis anywhere, and that does, you know, just that. It says, well, you know, it has to be on the x-axis somewhere, but it could be here, it could be there, wherever. And it once you do that, then you can say, well, you know, hey, I want to set up a little constraint between two points here, and just say, well, you know, I'm going to measure them, and they're supposed to be 5 meters apart, and so you'd set up the one guy as the target of this other guy and enter 5 meters or 5 units as the desired distance between the two, and that way it would stretch or squish whatever the coordinate system to adjust to that size. So the whole point of this thing, the whole point of the coordinate system setup, is to take your model here in 3D and tell it exactly how to put it out into the real world so that the 3D trackers match up, you know, correspondingly with the 2D ones, you know, and show up in your 3D environment exactly where you want. And when you do that, your 3D model shows up in the spot that you want, and then you can march into the house or whatever. I mean, you know, really what's going on somewhere out here, only in the 3D environment, is he doing the right motion? But when you put him into the scene at exactly the right spot, he shows up doing what he's supposed to. And just to point out, you know, people say, oh, you know, my object is sliding. And what that amounts to is you've not got the object in the right spot. So if my coordinate system is actually sitting here, and you've built Pokey up here, take away the coordinate system. Now, if my camera is moving, Pokey's standing up in the air here, and it looks like he's sliding around. So when you see that happen, it's telling you you don't have your object in the right position in the scene, and you need to adjust the coordinate system. And usually what you do is you look around, and you've got some 3D point in the object, you know, in your 3D environment, and, you know, it's matching up to the 2D spot, basically. And you need to use that 3D point to as a reference to decide exactly where you want to put the model in the scene. So, you know, if Pokey's, you know, right foot is right by a certain feature in the image, you want to match up his foot in 3D to that corresponding 3D tracker location. So I hope this helps everyone out. It's kind of a simple and direct sort of thing. Thanks a lot. I hope you enjoy it.